Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Mooney's Accounting Academy. In this video, I will explain to you past adjustments. But before going to that past adjustments, let us discuss something about P&L appropriation account. Because P&L appropriation account and past adjustments, both are related. So that's why just let us understand P&L appropriation account first, then we will go for past adjustments, right? So P&L appropriation account is just an extension of P&L account. P&L appropriation account is an extension of P&L account. That means, you know that trading and P&L account, okay? So this is trading account, you will get gross profit here. This gross profit is taken here on the credit side, you will put gross profit here, then you are getting P&L account, and here you are getting net profit here, okay? Net profit, this is P&L account, this is trading account, this is P&L account. The continuation of P&L account, continuation of P&L account is P&L appropriation account. Continuation of P&L account is P&L appropriation account. So that's why just it is an extension of P&L account, okay? So whatever the net profit you get here, so that comes on the credit side here. Net profit, okay? Net profit on the credit side. See how gross profit in the trading account is put on the credit side of P&L account. In P&L account, how the net profit you have got, so that net profit we will put here on the credit side. Suppose it is gross loss, we will put on the debit side. It is a different issue. So P&L appropriation, profit and loss appropriation. Appropriation means how we are dividing, how we are segregating. Appropriation means how much we are giving for this, how much we are giving for this, how much we are giving for this from our profit. That is called appropriation. Even this word appropriation is used by the central government, state government in their budgets. Understand, this much amount is appropriated for defense, this much of amount is appropriated for education. Appropriation, that means this much we set aside, this much you have allocated for this. So that is the meaning of appropriation. So here profit and loss appropriation means from the profit what you get, how much is given for this, how much is given for this, how much is given for this, so finally how much is left, okay? So here in P&L appropriation account, as I said, it is an extension of profit and loss account, okay? In profit and loss account, the firms get the profit, or sometimes it may incur loss. Suppose the firms are getting profit. In the partnership firms, they continue, they extend further the profit and loss account to a separate account, to an extended part, that is known as profit and loss appropriation account. It is a continuation. So it is only a continuation of P&L account, okay? So here what we write, net profit on the credit side, net profit on the credit side, okay? And this is a nominal account. Please remember it, it is a nominal account, right? So that's why whatever the firm's expenses, so that come to the debit side, and whatever the incomes firms are getting, that comes to the credit side. This is the nature of P&L appropriation account. So what are the expenses now? What kind of expenses you will show in P&L P&L appropriation account? Not relating to the firm. All the expenses relating to the firm are shown in P&L account. Now the expenses towards the partners. Understand? All the expenses towards the partners, right? So sometimes a partnership firm may have to give some salary to a partner. So that is an expense to the firm. So it comes to the debit side. Suppose interest on capital to be paid to the partners by the firm, it is an expense to the firm. So it comes to the debit side. So expenses of the firm towards their partners. So that will be appearing on the debit side. Okay. So expenses like interest on capital, salary to a partner, whatever the expenses that the firm is paying towards the partners, right? Suppose any bonus, any commission, all the expenses are shown on the debit side. Okay. And what are the incomes now to the partnership firm? Because when you are showing the expenses towards the partners, now what kind of income you will get from partner? So sometimes the partners may give you interest on their drawings. Understand? Suppose they have drawn something, they have withdrew something. So on that, if they are paying interest, then the firm is receiving it. So that is an income to the firm. So that's why the interest on drawings appear on the credit side, right? Any other appropriations, I said that this much of amount is set aside for this much of amount is set aside for this. So like that, suppose they want to set aside some amount for general reserve, it comes to debit side. So finally, suppose the credit total is more than the debit items total. Credit amount total, suppose it is more than the debit amount total, then you will be getting here net divisible profit. Net divisible profit. Okay. So when will you get net divisible profit? If your total credit side income is more than the expenses. So that is net divisible profit. So net divisible profit, when will you get? If your credit side is more than the debit side. Okay. Suppose reverse, net divisible loss. When will it happen? When debit is more and credit is less. This is net divisible loss. So whether it is net divisible profit or net divisible loss, that is to be distributed in the agreed ratio in between partners. If ratio is not agreed, then they will distribute the profit and loss equally. Okay. Is it clear now? What is P&L appropriation account? P&L appropriation account is an extension of profit and loss account. All the partnership firms prepare it. And it is a nominal account. All the incomes from the partner are shown on that credit side. All the expenses toward the partners, whatever the firm is paying the expenses to the partners, that comes to the debit side. And any other appropriation from the profit, like general reserve or some charity to the other government organizations, non-governmental organizations, all these come onto the debit side. Okay. And finally, take the balance. Suppose your credit is more, that means when your income is more than the expenses, naturally you get profit. Suppose your expenses are more than income, loss. So it is to be distributed in the prescribed agreed ratio. Okay. So this is about P&L appropriation account. So some questions are asked in the previous examinations. Why do we prepare P&L appropriation account? Answer: in order to show the appropriations of profit. What is the objective of preparing P&L appropriation account? In order to find net divisible profit or net divisible loss. How do we distribute net divisible profit or loss? In the agreed ratio. If there is no ratio, equal. So this is what P&L appropriation account. Okay. And then we will proceed for our topic past adjustments. Before proceeding to our topic past adjustments, I will take up one question on P&L appropriation account. I will explain it. Then I will tell you the connection between past adjustments and the P&L appropriation account. Okay, so let us take up one question. Prepare P&L appropriation account for the year ended 31st March 2020. Okay, and X and Y are partners sharing in the ratio of 3:2. What is given to us? Interest on capital, salary, commission, interest on drawings, and profit for the year 3,40,000 is given. Okay, now how to prepare P&L appropriation account? As just now I said, P&L appropriation account. P&L appropriation account is to be prepared like this. Okay. On the credit side, whatever the profit of the firm is given, so that will appear on the credit side. So by P&L account, 3,40,000. This is the starting item of P&L appropriation account. For your understanding, even I can write just here number 1. It is only for your understanding. Don't write in the examinations. This is the starting point. This should be the first item. So that's why just I put first 1 P&L account. How much profit is given? 3,40,000. Put here. Then, as I told you, this is a nominal account. Expenses on the debit side, any appropriations debit side, any income on the credit side. Now, in these items, what are the expenses to the firm? Interest on capital is a expense to the firm, because the firm has to pay interest on capital. To whom? To the partners. So it's an expense. So put it on the debit side. To interest on capital, how much? X 30,000 and Y 20,000. Okay, next, salary to X 5,000 per month. 5,000 per month. So in a year, 12 months. So 5,000 multiplied by 12. So to salary, 5,000 multiplied by 12, 60,000. Commission to Y 40,000. Commission is a lump sum payment. Understand? It doesn't depend on month. 40,000 commission. So that is also expense. So this is to whom? This is to X. Salary to X. Now commission. Commission to whom? Commission to Y. Commission to Y. Okay. So that is 40,000. You are giving commission to Y and you are giving salary to X. Interest on capital, all these are expenses. And interest on drawings, that means partners have withdrawn the amounts, some amounts from the firm, and they are paying interest to the firm. So that's why this is an income to the firm. So how much from X they collected in the form of interest on drawings? From X, the firm received 6,000 rupees. This is an income to the firm. So that's why it is shown on the credit side. From Y, 4,000. Okay. Now, let us calculate. This total is 3,50,000. And how much is on the debit side? Put 3,50,000 here. Debit side 1,50,000. Okay, so now how much you are getting balance? 50,000 and 1,50,000. 3,50,000 minus 1,50,000. 3,50,000 minus 1,50,000. 2,00,000. Okay, so what is this 2,00,000? This is net divisible profit. Net divisible profit. Okay, why we are getting profit here and how we are getting profit here? क्योंकि क्रेडिट डेबिट से ज्यादा है, इसीलिए प्रॉफिट आपको मिला है. ठीक है, क्रेडिट 3,50,000 और डेबिट का टोटल सिर्फ 1,50,000, राइट? सो यू गॉट 2,00,000 प्रॉफिट. दिस इज नेट डिविजिबल प्रॉफिट. नाउ हाउ टू डिस्ट्रीब्यूट दिस 2,00,000? इन विच रेशियो? 3:2, right? So this 2 lakhs you distribute to x and to y in 3:2 ratio. So 3:2 means what? X, how much share he will get? 2 lakhs multiplied by 3:2, that means 3/5. Okay, so 5/4 is 1,20,000, and y ko kitna milega? 2 lakhs 2/5, 80,000. So इधर लिखो 1,80,000 and 80,000, 1,20,000 and 80, 2 lakhs. Understand? This is what P&L appropriation account, right? Now just let us imagine, suppose you have not taken interest on capital, suppose you have forgotten this, what will happen then? Imagine, interest on capital, suppose you have forgotten, have not written, right? Otherwise, 30,000 ke jaga 60,000 likha hai. 30,000 likhna hai, lekin 60,000 likha hai. Then what will happen? This net divisible profit will be affected. Similarly, salary 60,000. 60,000 लिखना है लेकिन 6,000 लिखा है, राइट? सपोज यू मे कमिट सम मिस्टेक्स, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग, टू एरर इज ह्यूमन, नॉर्मल समटाइम्स वी मे कमिट मिस्टेक्स, नो वन इज एक्सेप्शनल फ्रॉम कमिटिंग मिस्टेक्स, राइट? सपोज इन पी एंड एल अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट इफ वी कमिट एनी मिस्टेक्स, अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट विल हैपन, दिस नेट डिविजिबल प्रॉफिट will be affected because of the mistakes. That's what I am saying. Suppose you have not shown interest on capital here, suppose it is not shown, then your net divisible profit will be more. That is wrong, because what will happen? Net divisible profit is distributed to partners. When this is wrong, this distribution is also wrong. When this distribution is wrong, capital accounts are wrong. And capital accounts are wrong, it is reflected in balance sheet, so balance sheet is also wrong, right? Please try to understand what is the meaning of balance sheet. Balance sheet is defined as a statement showing true and fair financial position. Understand? But you know that there are mistakes, and these mistakes are reflected there. That means true and fair financial position is affected, not shown. That means we are not fulfilling the objective, the purpose of balance sheet, right? So what actually you need to understand here, if any mistakes are there in P&L appropriation account, if they commit any mistakes in P&L appropriation account, how to rectify, what is the method, right? Kaun sa tarika use karna hai rectify karne ke liye, right? So here, that approach to rectify the mistakes in P&L appropriation account, we will discuss in past adjustments topic. I hope the concept is clear today. What is P&L appropriation account? I told you, P&L appropriation account is just extension of profit and loss account. It is an extension of profit and loss account. Objective of P&L appropriation account is to calculate net divisible profit, which is distributed to the partners in the agreed ratio. Expenses on the debit side, incomes on the credit side. If credit is more than the debit, you get profit. Agar debit jyada hai to loss. Theek hai? Now, suppose any mistakes are committed in P&L appropriation account preparation, then what is to be done? Kaun sa tarika use karna hai? That is past adjustments. Okay, so if you like my video, my explanation, subscribe my channel and share it with your friends. Thank you.